Okay. I'm gonna be helping help the wood. That.
Sammy, it's Mr. Crane. Are you in here?
Please don't hurt me!
Is that kid? Is he in here? Yep.
Go away! Leave me alone!
Easy, kid. Hey, it's all over. You all right?
My dad got hurt. He said he's becoming like the other sick people, and that he couldn't protect me anymore. He said if I came out of the cabinet, he would hurt me, but that once he was sick, I'd be safe. Because he wouldn't remember I was in there.
Your dad saved your life.
Where is he?
Sammy, he's gone. There's nothing anyone could do. Now listen, I have to get you back to your mom.
I wish I could have stayed with her.
Troy, it's Crane.
Go ahead.
I got a little boy here. He's been through a rough ride. He could use some spoiling.
I'll have someone there in 5 minutes.
Can we get him back to his mother at the tower?
I'll take him there myself if I have to.
Thanks, Troy.
Well. Find a way in. The zombies, find a way in for me. Make it interesting. Wait a minute.
I talked to Jade and told her I worked for the GRE. She was so furious she hung up on me. Well, at least I know where to look for her, thanks to Troy.
Survival of the fittest out here.
Yeah, and it's not easy going for you, buddy.
Hey!
Hi, buddy. It's time to clean house for you bitches. I feel like I have the super shotgun from Doom.
About
come for you assholes. That sounds weird. I'm not gonna say that again.
Fuck it.
You think? Now you see how I feel. Says from Left 4 Dead. Oh boys! I know there's more of you bitches. Somewhere.
No, I got you.
Oh, now you got me. Huh. Son of a fucking... There we go. Fuck a Molotov at me? Bitch.
I got you.
Motherfucker. I'm getting angry. Now. Your frickin' test spells out.
Come on.
Oh boy. Okay. Fucking demolishers. Well, I try to help you boys. Demolishers can't charge and throw objects at you. Use dodge frequently. No thanks. I don't want to fight them.
It's that dead meat smell and those sounds they make. It's enough to make your blood run.
Yeah. Why would you want to be in the fucking closet in the first place.
I never expected Haran's destiny to turn out so close to its intention. And yet, so far.
What do you mean?
Haran has always been something of an anomaly. It was originally settled in the Middle Ages, but it has always been an open city, a center of trade and commerce. Because of that, the prevailing attitude here has consistently been one of tolerance and acceptance. People of all nationalities, ethnicities, religions, all were welcome within Haran's borders, as long as they could pay the city's taxes.
Sounds like a good thing.
You would think. And for the most part, it has been. The aborted global athletics games would have highlighted the city's diversity.
So why do you sound so down about it?
Because the outbreak has demonstrated what I fear is one of the more fundamental elements of human nature. We divide ourselves. We divide ourselves and we look for an enemy. The survivors in the tower are a diverse lot, it's true. But who are we more frightened of? The infected? Or Ryze and his army of gangsters? And Ryze himself? I'm told his men are just as varied as those of us here. And yet, he sends them against us. If old lines fade, we draw new lines.
Okay, well, thanks for that bit of inspiration.
I'm gonna put you in there. Hi, buddy. Wrong thing, game. Thanks. Fancy. And for some fun, thank you, killed them all. Yes. Yes.
Shh, quiet! I heard something. We've got company!
Yes. Likely so. Ish. Why is that there? And I got you. Pathetic. Really? disappointed me. Well. And you fucks died. All of you. Bathroom. Seriously? This leads to a bloody bathroom.
Savvy, Crane here.
Everything all right?
I shouldn't be seeing any more orange vests for a while.
You did it! I'll tell everybody thank you.
Well, that was simple.
Are you the one who rescued that little boy?
How's he doing?
He's on his way back to the tower. Brecken sent a messenger through. He had to go back anyway, so he just took Sammy with him. He'll be with his mum by tomorrow.
Thanks, that's good to know. Maybe I'll see him back at the tower.
So you're the new running guy. I am Pajaram. I'm not much to look at, but I'm a man who can put money in your pockets. Real money. My scout locates viable predators, and the runner waves a red flag at them. They will then pursue you until you either give them the slip, or they eat your head. Both are acceptable outcomes for me.
So how much?
Since you're just getting started, your reward would be small. But that amount would increase as your successes accrued.
If you're looking for food, you've got to wait and get your rations like everyone else.
That's not why I'm here. I'm Crane. I'm a runner. Anything I should be looking for out there?
We're pretty much out of everything. Food, water, medicine. You wouldn't expect Old Town to be poorer than the slums, but it is. Got to admit, it makes me wonder about those rumors of a big supply cache hidden somewhere in the city. Too bad the one person who'd know if it's true is Thabit Erdl. You can't get anything out of him.
Where do I find him?
Across town. He's not dangerous. He's just difficult. He's the former town clerk, and he can be extremely bureaucratic about things. Try not to kill him, but if you have to kill him, I'll totally understand.
You look like someone who's afraid of nothing. And Zana knows the people like you. Zana was like you in her youth. Zana was protecting people. Well, but Zana was doing it for money. And you are a real hero, from what Zana has heard. Huh? Prostit for my insolence, but to Zana, you look as someone who would not refuse to help a child.
What do you have in mind?
This boy under Tariq's care. Poor thing looks helpless. Well, they both seem helpless. The boy survived something terrible, and Tariq thinks his brother is still in danger. If you could give him a helping hand...
Yeah, I get it, but I don't know if I'm right for this.
Oh, you are. Zana knows. Believe me. Do svidaniya.
Where'd you find him?
He just showed up. He barely talks, and when he does, he says some strange things. A lot of it is about someone named Mike. The only thing he had with him was this voice recorder. But this fella, Mike, it might be his brother. The kid says he left him behind. He asked me to go get him, but I don't think I can do it. It's too dangerous to take him with me, and I don't want to leave him here alone.
You know where he lived?
Dolma Street, Unit 11-2.
Okay, maybe I'll check it out.
Keep this recorder. Maybe it'll help you understand what happened there.
Yes, what is it?
Are you Mr. Thabit Erdl, the town clerk?
That was my title. However, all city authority has been dissolved by the GRE and the federal government. My title does not exist anymore. And therefore, I am no longer required or allowed to provide any services to you or anyone else. In conclusion, goodbye.
Not so fast, Mr. Erdl. The dissolution order requires all local officials to be at the service of the GRE and the provisional authority as needed.
Are you with the GRE?
I'm looking for information about a large supply cache hidden somewhere in the city.
Ah, you mean the bunker. Well, if you wish to take possession of it, you'll have to lodge a 201 needs of agency form, JP401 details of operation form, also a 606 compulsion of special authority form, oh, and a 302B declaration of emergency functions form. That last one has a 3-day turnaround in the best of circumstances. Which these are certainly not.
I need it now.
Well, then I suggest you employ the traditional method of accelerating the government process.
Which is what?
Bribery, of course. I need the official seal of the mayor embossing stamp. The mayor was last seen at the hotel. Find his room, and you should find the seal.
Thank you.
hang over! Is that all you got? Yeah, you fucked up! Now you're making... Yeah.
Wonderful. I promise to abuse this seal to the fullest extent of my corruption, which is considerable.
Tell me about the supply cache.
It was a necessary precaution. Old Town supports a very wealthy class of citizens. They knew the slum districts would exhaust their meager supplies, and that the wretched poor would then invade us, like a wave of locusts.
So you locked it up?
The bunker is under the town hall. I can monitor your progress on the city services band. Radio me if you need some paperwork from the office of the mayor. I'll be generating reams of it.
Thank you.
Thabit, are you listening?
Oh, if you're in the town hall, could you filch me some stationery from the city council president's chambers?
Where's the pass card to enter the bunker?
Ah, the pass card, of course. Due to a series of tragic events, the chain of custody of that card has frequently changed. But I believe it finally landed in the capable hands of Police Captain Halim. That's who you need to get it from.
Why hasn't he opened the bunker himself?
Regretfully, Captain Halim's interest in material things is no more. He frequently shambles around K Street with several other former police officers. Perhaps they have some vague recollection of their fraternity.
Thank you, Captain Halim.
Fidan wanted to tell you something. You should talk with him. His friend, Rupert, is a real magician when it comes to firearms.
All right, thanks for the tip.
Hey, one more thing.
Yeah?
You ever use a rifle out there? If you do, you should see our gunsmith, Rupert. That guy can craft a howitzer from a pop gun.
A silencer would be more useful, but where would I find him?
Well, that's the thing. He hasn't been in his workshop for a while. You might want to try his flat.
Maybe I'll do that.
Wanna jail?
Oh, you found me again. God bless you. Listen, I barely made it here. I was delivering more medicine when the monsters almost got me. I still have more to deliver, but I broke my damn leg trying to escape. Could you?
Yeah, I'll help. And maybe since you're laid up now, you finally get some rest, huh?
I'll give it my best shot. And listen, I'm giving you as much of the profits as I can, but, well, it's just no one has money anymore. You know one of my clients tried to pay me in chickens?
Crane! Good to see you again.
With Spike? Holy shit, how'd you get here?
Wasn't easy. Anyway, Brecken sends his best. And listen, from now on, you can always find me here, okay? Everything I had for you in the slums, that'll all be here too, so feel free to use it.
Yeah, thanks, Spike.
No problem, pal. See you next time.
Did you hear that loud music? Someone turned it up on purpose. I wonder why. That guy must have a death wish.
Crane, I'm Mort Norris. Worked in Town Hall before the outbreak. Modernization of maintenance of hydraulic infrastructure department. Oh, one hell of a job, I'm telling you. Miss it more than I miss my kids these days.
Okay. So, you wanted to ask me something?
Yes, I was supposed to get water running in my neighborhood again. But I can't because of those damn undead and it's killing me. Could I persuade you to do it, please? It would be a great civic gesture, appreciated by tens, maybe dozens of people.
Oh, what would I need to do?
Just redirect the flow of water again. That's all. It'll be such a help. It'll even get our beautiful fountain up and running again.
Yeah, right. So what do you want me to do then?
Great. Great. Fantastic. You just have to get to these three pumping stations and switch the valves. Here, I'll show you where they are.
By order of the mayor, the entire contents of this bunker now belongs to me! Get away from it, thief!
Isan, this is Crane. I'm in a supply bunker under the town hall. I think we hit the jackpot.
That's great news, Crane. Thank you. Did you actually get Tapit to help you?
Yeah, but I had to kill him in the end.
I totally understand.
Thank you.
Face on the posters. You've got to help me.
What happened to you?
I took a bullet from Razor's men. I'm a runner too. Well, almost. Look, I'm out of commission. Can you help me out? I need you to finish this run for me.
Look, I'll get you to a shelter or something, but I've got other things to take care of.
You don't have anything more important than this, I guarantee it.
All right. Tell me what you got.
The source of the epidemic.
Where?
David can show you. Here's a list and a bag with the things I already collected. The rest is on you. When you've got it all, take it to David. He'll tell you everything. You'll find him at the Royal Canal. Tell him Spider sent you.
What about you?
I've got a safe house nearby. I'll be fine. Just help David. That's all that matters.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you did.
Anybody here? Who's there?
Crane, Spider sent me.
Why? What's happened to him?
He ran into Rice's people, but he'll be all right. Like, I brought the things he was collecting for you.
You're a lifesaver. Thanks, Crane. This is really going to make a difference.
So, tell me what this is all about.
Oh, I thought you knew.
I know it involves the source of the epidemic.
Yes, the meteorite. I know where it landed.
You think the epidemic came from space?
You think that's a coincidence?
You have some proof of this?
I did. Rice's men just took off with my last samples. I was going to send Spider out for some more. Could you do it?
Thank you.
All right, I've reached the site. I don't see anything.
All right, listen. The meteor shards react to green light. That makes them easier to spot. The Azmat guys put up some lamps and a generator. They should still be working.
Oh, hell. Should probably stop pulling this trigger.
Yeah!
I've got your meteor fragments.
Good. I'll load the shards into the accelerator chamber, and we'll be ready to take the fight to the reptilians.
Whoa, wait, whoa. Who are we taking the fight to?
Okay, technically they're Gadoids from Orion, but reptilians is a recognized euphemism, even if it's a bit redneck.
Uh-huh. And these Gadoids did what now?
Please. They came to Earth eons ago, and formed the Order of the Illuminati. Now they want to dominate us and spread around the entire fourth level. They have been turning people into slaves. But now you're going to stop them, because you have this.
I do?
Remember, it's not going to cut through a fast variable gamma shield, but short of that, it should deatomize anything out there.
Right. Got it. Anything else?
I'd estimate you can count on 500 charges before you need to replace the meteor shards. So go get them, soldier. Send them to hell. Envoyez-les à l'enfer!
Gee, thanks, David. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
know why you are here. Your nemesis awaits you. He has waited a long time.
That sounds like you've met him.
He once sought my visions for his advantage, but I will not share my gift with such a man as him. With you, I will.
How much will that cost?
The price will be high, but your payment will not be to me. Now you will go to the river. There is a pungent nightshade that reveals itself only in the moonlight. The smolder of its embers enables the seeker to pierce the veil.
All out, are we?
Bring me several stalks of this plant.
Maybe I will. In the meantime, you should shut off the music. It draws attention.
Nothing enters that I do not wish. Now, I must prepare my mind.
Crane, I was looking for Rupert.
No, you weren't. You were looking for a gunsmith who happens to be named Rupert.
Right, fair enough. Would like to talk about some weapon modifications?
You work for Rise?
No.
Well, I suppose that helps. But I'm waiting for my wife Jasmine to come back. Until she's here, I can't leave.
Has she been gone long?
No, not long. So it'll probably be a while before she returns.
And what about these kids? Are their parents...
dead, I hope. Every day, I'm terrified that one of them is going to look out the window and see their mother or father shambling down the street. I don't know what I'm going to do when that happens.
What have you told them?
Half-truths. That a dark magic has taken over the city, but that I am a good wizard who can protect them. It's the sort of game that doesn't end. Jasmine is better at this sort of thing. Hell, I'm a gunsmith. What am I doing playing this magical nonsense?
Seems to me you're doing pretty well.
Well, I'm not. There's a girl named Isla. She's a diabetic. Only her insulin ran out a while ago. Now her blood sugar is sky high. She's dehydrated and exhausted. Jasmine says if she doesn't get some insulin soon, she'll slip into a coma and die. And here I am in this stupid wizard hat, and the kids are waiting for me to cure her with a magic potion. Maybe it's time to tell them the truth. There is no good magic, only the dark kind.
Take it easy, Rupert. There's a drugstore in town. Maybe I can find some insulin there.
Are you serious? Mister, if you could do that, I can't tell you how grateful I'd be. I've got a radio here. If my wife Jasmine comes back, I'll probably go home for a while. But I'll let you know before I leave.
No!
Insulin here.
Holy shit!
I don't see any insulin. Troy, can you hear me? It's Crane.
Yes, Crane. What do you need?
There's a bunch of kids in the Magic Fortress. Did you know about this?
It's news to me. We thought that place was empty. Do they need assistance?
From what I've seen, yes.
It's going to take time to get anyone over there.
Understood. I'll stay until someone arrives. Hey, look, in the meantime, I need insulin. I'm at the drugstore now, but it's been picked clean.
Maybe you could check and see if the computer works. There should be records of people who bought the insulin last, along with their addresses. Maybe they still have it?
Thanks, Troy. Out. Rupert, this is Crane. Look, no luck here.
Damn it. Isla's lying down. She doesn't look right. I think we're almost out of time.
Oh, but there is a receipt here for insulin sold to someone named Ekram Bozkurt. That ring a bell?
That's Isla's father. Maybe he left the insulin at their home. His address is on the receipt.
All right, I'll head over and have a look. I'm driving to the pharmacy to get Alia's medication, then to Farhat Pizzeria, And then I'll pick up Alia from daycare. We should be home with dinner by 6. We love you, my darling, Ekram. So he got to the pharmacy, but he never picked up his daughter. Rupert, where's Farhad Pizzeria?
What?
Just get me the address.
It's near the Magic Fortress on Mercantile Street.
I can't believe you've done it.
Will she be all right?
Yes, yes, it's exactly what she needs. I'll take care of Isla, but could you keep the other children busy while I'm with her?
Yeah, well, I'm pretty busy.
Just talk to them. That's all you need to do. I've already told them you're a great warrior, like a knight.
You did? When's your wife coming back?
You'll be fine. I just need a few minutes. Children! This heroic warrior has returned with a healing elixir for Isla. Now he's going to stay here and be your protector while I administer the elixir to Isla.
Well now, hang on, wait.
I won't be long.
Hey there, bud. What's your name?
Kadeem.
Kadeem. I like that name.
I have a secret.
Really? Oh, so do I.
What's your secret?
I'm a GRE agent. What do you got?
Can you get my blocks for me?
But that's not really a secret.
But some of them are downstairs, near the basement. And Mr. Rupert said we're not ever to go near the basement. Not ever. But I went down there just to see. And I heard a scary sound, and I kind of dropped my blocks. They're kind of all over. Could you get them back for me?
Huh. That's a tall order, but I'll give it a shot. Here you go, Kadeem. All blocks accounted for.
Thanks. Hey, are you going to tell Rupert about this?
So, will you keep my secret?
That you work for the... Who is that again?
Your secret's safe, Kadeem. But I'm gonna talk to Rupert about those noises in the basement. I heard them too.
Isla's okay. She's sleeping now. She'll need some time to fully recover. Thank you again, Mr. Crane. My wife Jasmine should be back any time now, and since I know how tiring these kids can be, I'm sure you'll be wanting to move on.
No, not just yet.
But, well, our supplies are very limited.
Look, this is too much responsibility for one person, Rupert. I've sent for help. They'll be here soon.
That's not necessary. Jasmine and I can handle things just fine.
Rupert, I was downstairs.
Oh, I see.
I'm sorry, Rupert.
Sometimes in those noises, I think I can still hear a tiny trace of her voice. I was hoping it would be over by now, but I couldn't do it. My wife, my beautiful, beautiful Jasmine.
This has to end.
I would let her kill me before I would lift a finger to harm her.
Just give me the basement key.
Did you find her? Were you able to help her?
She has peace now.
Thank you. From both of us. I hope somewhere I may find forgiveness for what I did, for what I couldn't do.
I'm afraid I have to, sweetie. But some friends are coming to help you guys out. They'll be here really soon.
What if the troll gets them?
What troll?
There's a giant troll down in the parking lot. He makes lots of very scary noises, so it's hard to sleep.
Oh, well, that's no good. Maybe I'd better chase him away. And we can't have trolls in the parking lot, can we?
No, sir.
Clear out here.
Hey, that was a troll.
Wait, what?
That's the troll.
Of course it is. Scratch one troll.
Crane, this is Rupert. You're all right?
Yeah, but kids are a lot more work than I realized.
That's the truth. Look, your friends arrived, so I'm turning in my wizard hat and headed back to my workshop. I want you to meet me there. I owe you one hell of a debt, and it's time for me to pay it.
And I'll meet you there.
Thank you.
Glad you made it. You did me a heck of a favor back at the Magic Fortress.
Happy to help.
And I'm happy to pay you back, so have a look around. If you see anything you want, it's yours. On the house.
This will do very nicely. Thanks.
Thank you. And good luck, Crane.
Let's see what this says.
Detective Julie and his assistant begin their search for the missing person of Dolma Street. Oh, come on, you have to help me. Dad's been out all day. Come on, we're going to find him. The missing person of interest went out very normally to get some food, only to become missing under mysterious circumstances. Detectives Mike and Tom Dooley are sent to look for clues in the other apartments.
All right, boys, you were playing detective. What happened next? Okay, what now?
Detective Julie reporting. I'm entering the basement to check the trace. Mike, are you here? Mike, is that you?
Jesus.
Mike! 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 Mike!
And that was Mike.
Meat.
Case closed.
Come here. I've got a special deal for you.
You're back. Did you find Mike?
Mike was his dog. He's dead. And so is his father. It wasn't even the infected, it was just some twisted creep.
This place is too much for people. Listen, Crane. These are the keys to the museum storage. There's a lot of weapons from all different times. Maybe you'll find something useful there.
Thanks, Tariq. Hey, but there's something else I want from you.
Sure. Anything.
You said you're not good with kids?
No, not really.
Well, get good.
I will try. I give you my word.
Place the stalks in the brazier, and we will begin.
Now what happens?
Speak no more. The rising sun will lead you to the Fountain of Crying Blood, near the place where people are speaking tongues. You must follow the red trail to be enlightened. Under the deceitful number 9, the shadow of a self-proclaimed king we'll be waiting for you. The king with whom you shall have to fight. You'll find out who he is and what his weaknesses are. When the time comes, you will take his crown or die.
Think those biters out there are dangerous? What you gotta watch out for is right in here, locked up with us. Yeah, I'm talking about people. Of course, I'm talking about people. You know why? Because people are goddamn unpredictable. Biters, you know what they're gonna do? They're gonna bite you. But you got somebody who needs to live in the good life. Somebody spoiled, pampered, and then all of a sudden they're sleeping on the floor and eating cat food, and nobody gives two fucks who they are anymore. That kind of thing, and you pay attention to this, that kind of thing will screw with your mind worse than any zombie. Zombies, that's too strange, too far out of the human experience, too far off script for most people's minds. But somebody who's used to living like a king, and now they're worse than a beggar, they understand that. And they're the ones to watch out for, because they will fucking snap in a heartbeat, and you don't have the slightest idea what they're capable of or what they'll do. So be careful. And keep a weapon handy.
Yeah. I'll be sure to keep an eye out for homicidal one percenters.
Ah!
Speaking tongues. The hotel would have been full of foreigners. Maybe that's it. Well, he's either clairvoyant or I'm being set up. Guess the deceitful nine must be a room number then. Seven is the last room. Deceitful Nine, of course. Now how do I find a key in all this mess? deceitful nine, of course. Rice's room. He must have set up shop here when the epidemic first began.
Recognize him?
Mm-hmm.
I've switched all three valves.
Brilliant. Now, you just have to do the same in the main pumping station. Give me a shout once you're there.
Okay, what now?
Look for the main valve.
See that?
Any progress?
Yes, yes! We've got water again, not just in our building, but in my whole district, too. You did my job and you did it well. Even the fountain works again. Amazing, Crane.
Good. Yeah, it's better to drink water than energy drinks.
Yeah.
Want a deal?
Thank you.
If you can make yourself useful, I can make it worth your while.
What do you have in mind?
I don't want to say it out loud. If you... make sure it's worth your while. We will have to make get the message? I'm going to kill you!
I'll do it. Lead the way.
Busted and dusted. He's
You're good, mister. You're real good. A lot of runners panic when the Horde shows up. They take to the rooftops. But not you. You stand your ground. Makes it easy to pay you. Thanks.